get out of here.
Back in the house.
He's gone. He's left town. Look, if you don't believe me, the garage. He took the car. Oh!
Where is he?
I told you he's gone. I don't know where he is. I don't know when he'll be back.
Upstairs. Got it nice here, hasn't he? Real nice. So there won't be any misunderstanding. Tell him I'll be back.
If you are, the police will be here to meet you.
Better check with your husband. I don't think he'd like that.
Why don't you leave us alone? Why don't you go away? He never did anything to you. I know all about you. He told me all about you. He thinks he has to protect you, but I'm not going to. I don't care what you went through together. You're just a minute.
What did he tell you about me? What did he tell you? Did he tell you that I'm a cripple because of him? Did he tell you about the men that are dead because of him? Did he tell you what happened to them before they died? Mike Garby? He had a wife and a kid, too. Made a nuisance out of himself, showing everybody their picture. Afterwards, somebody got the picture back. It was so covered with blood, you couldn't tell what it was. And the other men were moaning outside the wire all night long. I was lucky. They thought I was dead and left me there.
But it's not his fault. He had nothing to do with it.
He was a stool pigeon for the Nazis.
You're lying. You're crazy. He told me you were crazy. They even had to put you in the hospital because you were crazy.
Sure, I was in the hospital. But I didn't go crazy. I kept myself sane. You know how? I kept saying to myself, Joe, you're the only one alive that knows what he did. You're the one that's got to find him, Joe. I kept remembering. I kept thinking back to that prison camp. One of them lasted till morning. By then, you couldn't tell his voice belonged to a man. He sounded like a dog that got hit by a truck and left in the street.
Get out! Get out of here and leave us alone!
Save it. He isn't worth it.